Hello everyone, my name is Manika Majumdar and I am working as an assistant professor for the Department of Food Nutrition and Dietetics at Milagros College. Today I am going to start with the topic carbohydrates. In this topic we are going to cover structure, function, uses and classification of carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are the most abundant biomolecules in the living system. It comprises 50% of the Earth's biomass. Carbohydrates are the major source of energy. Today in this session, I'm going to discuss about carbohydrates, function, classification, and sources. Carbohydrates are the most abundant naturally occurring biomolecules. They are mainly composed of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. They have a general formula of CN in bracket H2O N, where C stands for carbon, H hydrogen, and O oxygen, and N symbolizes the numerical values. Carbohydrates are also known as hydrates of carbon because here the carbon is attached with water molecules. Carbohydrates are chemically defined as a polyhydroxyaldehyde or polyhydroxyketone. Upon hydrolysis, it gives rise to such units. Let's take some examples of carbohydrates. Glucose, as you can see in the structure, glucose has an aldehyde functional group and several hydroxyl groups attached to the carbon backbone, which described as a polyhydroxy aldehydes. Functions of carbohydrate. One of the most important function of carbohydrate is it provides energy. Most of the energy we get from the oxidation of glucose in the cell. Second function of carbohydrate is it acts as an energy storage. It serves as a storage form of energy. In our body, it is stored as the glycogen, and in plant, it's stored as a starch. The third function of carbohydrate is it acts as a structural component. Example, glycoproteins and glycolipids. They are found on the plasma membrane of the cell. Peptidoglycan, it is one of the component of cell wall of bacteria. Cellulose, it is also a component of the cell wall in plants. And we all know cell wall helps to give a shape to a cell. And the fourth function of carbohydrate is it is a precursor for the synthesis of amino acids and fats. Sources of carbohydrates. Cereals is one of the richest source of carbohydrate, where the carbohydrate starch is present abundantly. Fruits, where glucose, fructose, and sucrose are present. Vegetables, where starch and some complex carbohydrates are present. And milk is also a source of carbohydrate like lactose. Let's move on to our next slide, that is classification of carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are classified in various ways. First, classification is based on their taste. Carbohydrates are classified into sugars and non-sugars. Sugars, they are sweet in taste. They are crystalline and water soluble. Examples of sugars are like glucose, fructose, lactose, and sucrose. Non-sugar carbohydrates, they are not sweet in taste, they are amorphous and not soluble in water. Example, starch. Based on the number of monomeric unit, also we can classify the carbohydrates. They are monosaccharide, oligosaccharide and polysaccharides. Monosaccharides are made up of one sugar units, that is one monomeric units. Example, glucose, fructose and galactose. Next is oligosaccharide. Oligosaccharides, they are made up of 2 to 10 sugar units. Examples, lactose, maltose and sucrose. Polysaccharides, these are the carbohydrates which are made up of more than 10 monomeric units. Example, starch, glycogen and cellulose. As you can see in the slide, glucose is a monosaccharide and it's made up of one monomeric unit. Sucrose is a disaccharide, means it made up of two monomeric unit. Starch is a polysaccharide which is made up of several monomeric unit. First we will take up the monosaccharide. Monosaccharides are also known as simple sugars. They are consist of a polyhydroxyaldehyde or ketone units. These cannot be further hydrolyzed into smaller units. Most abundant monosaccharides in nature is glucose, which is also known as dextrose. Examples of monosaccharides are glucose, fructose and galactose. As you can see, this is the structure of glucose in Fischer projection. This is the cyclic form of glucose in Howarth projection. Fructose, this is the structure of fructose in Fischer projection and the cyclic form of fructose in Howarth projection. These monosaccharides are again classified in two ways, based on their functional group and based on their number of carbons. Let's see how we can classify the monosaccharide based on their functional group. They are of two types, aldoses and ketoses. Aldoses are the monosaccharide which contains aldehyde groups. Example, glucose, mannose, galactose and ribose. As you can see here, this is the structure of glyceraldehyde. Glyceraldehyde is an aldose sugar. So at first position there is an aldehyde group and it also has two hydroxyl groups. Ketoses. Monosaccharide containing ketone group are called ketoses. example fructose and ribulose. So dihydroxyacetone is a keto sugar, and as you can see, the ketone group is present at second position. In a monosaccharide, aldehyde group is always present in first position and ketone group is always present at second position. Based on the number of carbon atoms, we can also classify the monosaccharide. When there are three carbon atoms in a monosaccharide, then these are called as trioses. Examples: glyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetone. Next, tetroses. Tetroses is composed of four carbon atoms. Example: erythrose and erythrolose. Pentoses are the monosaccharides which composed of five carbon atoms. Example: ribose, ribulose, xylulose. Hexoses are the monosaccharide which composed of six carbons. Example: glucose, fructose. And heptoses are composed of seven carbon atoms. Example: aldohexoses and cetoheptulose. As you can see, the structures of monosaccharides like trioses, because they have three carbon atoms, erythrose, which has four carbon atoms. So that's why it's called as tetroses. Ribose is a pentose sugar, or pentoses, because it has five carbon atoms. And allose, which contains six carbon atoms. So, let's take an example of glyceraldehyde. Glyceraldehyde has an aldehyde group and three carbon atoms. So, we can say glyceraldehyde is a aldotrioses. In the same manner, pentose sugars, that is ribose, it is containing five carbon and one aldehyde group. So we can say it as a aldopentosis. For fructoses, as it contains one ketone group, which is a functional group, and total six carbon atoms are present, so they are called as ketohexoses. With this note, I am going to end today's session. Thank you.